So, Johnny, maybe not the likeliest of heroes, but Tom Russell, doing the goods, hero of the night.
All right, well, brilliant. Absolutely fantastic. 16-year-old lad, local lad, Salford kid, and his granddad being a president, and sort of set up for him, weren't it? You know, and everyone's buzzing for him. You know, he's got a smile like the Cheshire Cat in there, and buzzing for him. Yeah, he deserved that, because he's a young man in a big league and around some, you know, big characters, and he fits in really well, and he's deserved what he's got. Brilliant.
And a big game to put into. Both teams played big, strong sides, big physical teams, showing the respect to Hyde. And were you a little bit disappointed it went all the way?
No, because not an arrogant comment, but I think it's a big game for both sides. It's a quarter final of a cup. Hyde aren't having the greatest of seasons in the league, and probably felt that they had a chance of winning this cup. You know, we put out a strong side, all right. People look at it and say maybe fringe players over the last few games, but they're all first team players, every single one of them, barring Alain, who made his debut at centre-half, and young Tom, who played in the last round. But we have no qualms of putting Tom in. You know, he played in the last round against Stirling, he earned the right to play. And we put a strong side out there, but teams don't... You very rarely see teams in cup games from two or three leagues below getting absolutely hammered. I thought the pitch always play a big part when you're away from home on a 3G surface, because they're used to it, they train on it, they know the bounce. It's a brilliant surface, by the way. The best one we've seen. But I thought for the first half an hour, 40 minutes, it felt like they had the upper hand in terms of understanding the pitch a little bit better. We were slow out of the blocks. We went through one or two things at half time, as you can probably imagine, and I started to be a little bit more brave in the second half, show a little bit more determination, and show that they want to win this trophy as much as me and Burn and probably everyone else at the football club do. And you can see how much it matters to the supporters with another good turnout. So it was important to us that we pushed them all the way, and instead of just accepting it, or, you know, we wanted to get back in the game, whichever way it came.
And our chances into the last four now, and obviously it's something that we do want to go and win. Feeling more optimistic now?
You're in the last four of a competition. You're in the last four of a cup. You know, so all the big sides are left in it. You know, the Conference North teams and some big clubs in it. So nobody's going to go in there and think, oh, I'm happy to go out in the semi-finals. Everyone wants to win the cup. You know, we had lads today who all wanted to play. You know, Sam Walker was desperate to get on the pitch. He didn't get on. You know, Nick Horton, Jordan, Michael got on the pitch, and then you've got all the lads in the stand who played on Saturday. There was 10 changes from Saturday, but when you look at that team and the players that played, you know, it's a first team 11. You know, it's like last year when we put me and Bernard played in the competition, and a few of the under 18s. We didn't do that this year. We decided we wanted to give everyone the opportunity. We don't believe in resting players as such, but you know, you've got a big squad and everyone's got to play a part. So I thought for the first, as I said, the first half, it probably took a little bit of time for the lads who hadn't played for a while, but they showed big character second half when they were up against it, and it was good to see.